It was for exiting Kerbin, but I had it just automatically create the next SOI, and it didn't, it did not do what I wanted it to do. Unfortunately. Tell me it was fueled. Okay, it was fueled at least. Build a bunch of rockets and try to move Kerbin. You can't. It's actually on rails. Physics won't allow that. Unfortunately. Alright, Dad, blame it. Kerbal alarm clock. Add an alarm for the SOI change for the KSA Filet. 97 days. When is this? That's 127 days. That's 110 days. So 97 days is completely first. 97 days is completely first. And that is a landing trajectory, of course. Of course it's a landing trajectory. Ay, 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 mamacita. Okay, that's set now at least. Now we just have to burn a little bit prograde. Tell me that's prograde right there. Excellent, eh? Look, we can totally just do that and make it get whatever orbit it wants. Yeah, I did. VB Knight. Thank you for watching, VB Knight. I don't recognize your name, but thank you for getting my back, basically. So, now all I need to do is this. Put into a freaking aerobrake trajectory. About a 600 on the Apoaps, because that guy there is at 100. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6-ish. That's okay. He's set now. And then this one, I think we're just going to let this one go. Let's go see what its encounter looks like. Oh, it's landing, apparently, so we've got to fix it. Whew, look at that. It won't actually aerobrake. We've got to do this one. Phone called, forgot to deploy the chutes. You were 1,000 meters from the ground deployed. What a thug. Kerbal was just smiling. All right. Ah, yeah, we did. We did burn after creating the SOI alarm. So let's, Yeesh. It's a little rough, honestly. I don't think I did the first time, but, this is in 98 days, and the other one is in 97 days. So that's fine. Alright, that's fine, whatever. These craft can do whatever this craft wants to do. Yeah, we totally did the Rosetta Filet mission. We did a gravity slingshot off the moon, we got out to this asteroid, we have the Rosetta, the Dr. Pepetta craft here, and we have the Filet, the KSA Filet, because I can't pronounce filet. Why can't you wag? What do you mean I can wag? I can wag. Where are the screenshots in the Placey, McBobber? The screenshots in Steam, where do you find those? How terrible this would end up with near or far. Why would that end up terrible? I mean, can you point the asteroid prograde? I don't think so, can you? Now, we have to launch our other craft into a retrograde orbit. So let's do that right quick. Space Center. Well, F5 for safety right freaking here. And I can't F5 for safety in the VAB. I can't F5 right here either. I can F5 in a flight scene. Where's the KSA Hugs? There we go. Oh, no. Alright, whatever. I know who you meant to line, dude. I know who you meant. Alright. We have to go into a retrograde orbit. Which is interesting. A retrograde orbit. Because Because we don't really have anything that could toss that thing into a prograde orbit right now. But we can go retrograde from Kerbin into prograde around Minmus, which is where we're going to go eventually. We may do that another time. We'll probably do that another time. Yes, I need to F5. And I need to launch into a retrograde orbit. How much Delta V did I have? 3183 plus that. Okay. Check inclination. Inclination's okay. I mean, it's close enough to flat that we'll deal with it. It'll be okay. Let's just go straight into a retrograde orbit. Throttle up, panel lock, SAS engage, Kerbal alarm clock off. I mean, that's coming up in 97 days, so I don't even know how those things got into the sphere of influence. Anyways, let's go to space. Hey, Sol, you like my launch clamps on my launch clamps on my launch clamps? Look how launchy it is. They all decouple. And then the rocket falls over. Oh, underglow. There you go. Sit in a Kerbal. Oh no, did I just... I can't just add it to it, can I? After it's launched. Ay, 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 ay. I am beginning to not pay attention. You said sitting in a Kerbal and I didn't understand what you meant. That's my bad. Oh, we got it. Oh, we're also controlling it from the weird node. Now we're good. Whew. Skittles, I guess. Need more snacks. None, Cy Young, none. You have no credits. None. So we had 100 and something Delta V left over last time we went to a 90 kilometer orbit. Let's see the difference turning retrograde instead of prograde, turning west instead of east. Tarling almost overslept his ride, nice. So we're turning west instead of east this time. Nah, I just like Skittles in general. I'm okay just eating Skittles in general. Underglow. It's more like interior glow. Darth Lazarus, thanks for the follow. I forget it. Jeez, run out already. Come on. There we go. So cool. Yes, Align Dude, you do. Not very big, Soul. It's a C. We're just playing around with tweak scale. Good times. We should totally redesign this with a cupola. With a forward-facing cupola. We really should. What's up, MC with a bunch of random numbers? How goes it? Tand, yes, you can pronounce my name Lazarus. Thank you. Sadly gave to go now. Food luck with your mission. What? I think my tingly spider sense tells me that you're trying to tell me that you have to go and you're wishing me good luck with my mission. Yay or nay? /105 It's going to be 1400. We only have 1087 in the tank. That's actually quite a bit. Tis Pi. Oh, 31314159265. Nice. Tis Pi. Such SAS. I'm coming for you, asteroid. I'm coming to grab you, and then hug you, and love you forever. Can you build a submersible? There's some mods that let you, but not in stock. You probably could, but it would be too big, because this is going to decouple and be an engine. This is an engine. This is just a kicker stage. Whoa! Get out of here! And apparently we can't go straight with this. The game does not like this up here. It is not balanced at all. 115 by 99, what a pitiful orbit. What is this, 115 by 99? This is the hugs right here. We really need a low pro thing and we need to balance it better because it's not very balanced right now. All right. App Ops. Periaps is coming up next. We don't want a Periaps to come up next, so we're going to burn Skyward. Like this. Now we could actually burn Retrograde and even out this orbit a little bit. Because we are at the Apoaps right now. See how this isn't moving? That's the time to circularize. When that gauge right there is not moving, that's when you want to circularize. Because that's when your Periaps or your Apoaps won't actually change, but your other one will. That is how you do that. Just let them go for balance. That's actually kind of almost sort of wrong. It actually is powerful enough engines you can just burn down into the water. Interesting. I've never tried that. I've never tried that. Burning down into the water. Interesting idea. What is that going by? Oh my goodness, what is that? 14 kilometers away. The delicious delivery ship just passed us. Oh man. Coded threat, drink! Able to handle the. Well, on average, we have two correctly scaled things. I want to be able to grab all the asteroids ever. We're just going to make a collection. And we're going to take them wherever we want. Do fuel tanks sink when full? I don't know. I've never tried any of that stuff. I thought there was a mod that did that. A decent depth, I saw someone that reached the ocean floor with burning downwards? Really? I didn't know that. That is interesting. The mod knew that was the delicious ship. It is so weird to be in a retrograde orbit. So weird. This guy needs to be fixed too. It doesn't burn evenly. We could probably make it a lot better if we did RCS right. I have not seen. Undock with that thing and grab it with the claw. Undock what thing and grab it with the claw? What are you talking about, solid tequila? That sounds delicious, by the way. Klubi, thanks for the follow. We're going to get ourselves an asteroid, apparently. That will balance. Oh, undock that and grab it with the claw. I see what you're saying. That's actually really smart. I'm not really too worried about it. I was just whining a little bit. Being Whiny McWinerson, honestly. It's really not that big of a deal. We'll be able to fly around just fine like this. Why am I not an orbital camera? There you go. If I bite you there... Yeah. Yeah, we want to carry everything with this, and we could actually dock additional fuel onto it if we needed to. That's probably something we should have done. Blastin' Bastin, thanks for the follow. F5 for safety. Let's go out to those other craft. There are the inbound asteroids. There's the Pipetta. Alright. The Dr. Pipetta. And there's our asteroid. With our fillet of fish on it. Node time is coming up in how long? 97 days. F5 for safety right here. Now let's go. The Dr. Pipetta. I don't even care about the Dr. Pipetta. The float bags are filled with fuel? Really? What's up, Mybum? That's an interesting name, Mybum. Cool. What's going on? I really need to play some Long Dark. I'm late. I'm not really going to transfer credits around, Alex. How many credits do you have? Anyways, what am I doing here? 9695 4321. Nice, we're 30 kilometers behind now. Oh yeah, Meister. Skittles, make that say S5 for safety. Whoa! Dude, Cy Young Mi, thank you for that. Thanks for all your tutorials and hours of enjoyable streaming. That was completely out of the blue. I really appreciate that. I'm just like sitting here doing an asteroid, and all of a sudden my ears explode, and it's really loud, and then I look over there, and it's an awesome donation. Thank you for that. I appreciate you. I really do appreciate the donation. Thank you very much. I know, Cy Young Mi, that's the thing. I keep it really loud, because that makes it really loud for me. That makes it really loud for me. I could turn it down a little bit. I know I could. Where's the stream tip thingy? It's almost all the way down, which is interesting. It doesn't make any sense. It wakes everybody up. Anytime anybody wants to wake anybody up, they can just send a donation. Thank you very much. Again, thank you very much, Cy Young Mi. Oh, man. I don't even know how to say how much I appreciate that. That's just really cool. That is just really cool. I mean, I'm just sitting here hanging out with y'all. ACR 6007, Phoenix 66 as well, thanks for the follow. And Cy Young Mi is totally awesome. Hi, yi. I'm just playing video games and hanging out with y'all. And I mean, my excuse is that we're learning stuff, right? But still, we're playing video games and hanging out and laughing and having fun. Like, what kind of life is that? That is so freaking amazing that that's even possible. Look at the asteroid. We've got the asteroid coming in. We've lost the other probe. That means that it's a pretty good distance away. Is that the other probe? Nope, that is the, is that it? The Dr. Pipetta is over there. What a weird place for the Dr. Pipetta to be. I don't buy that for a second. What can you do, though? Every time, whatever's going on, you want a first class ticket on the cruise liner. I'll remember that, Cy Young Mi. I'll totally remember that. I will totally remember that. Wap, wap, kaka. Very interesting name. I will remember that. I was just going to use credits for it, right? Oh, coded threat. Minimus is so easy to get to. Minimus is... I'll show you how to get to Minimus really easy. It's insanely... It's almost easier than the moon to get to. Not necessarily easier than the moon, but it's as easy as the moon to get to. You just gotta click a lot. I'm so peeved that this isn't arrow breaking. I'm so peeved that this is not arrow breaking. Lucifer, we're doing good. Ooh, 127 credits, Cy Young Me. I don't know if that's enough to buy, but $25 definitely is, so. I am slightly perturbed that that is happening that way. Whatever. 17 hours, that's nuts, man. Well, we're just gonna have to catch this thing live. I don't even care. You've been to all the planets. Nice! Meister Carl has a challenge to get to Minimus by the next... End of the next week, I think, right? End of the next week, I think it is. Where is the other ship? There it is. It's hidden in this whiteness. The KSA Hugs. There it is. You can't see it. There it is. Switch to. Alright, let's go capture an asteroid. You've left quite a few Kerbal Knots on the surface of Eve. Nice. Are you in the Dr. Pepessa's? Oh, Les Claypool, you can't do a gravity tug like that. Like, the other craft doesn't have any gravity. It won't do that. So that wouldn't have pulled us out of the SOI. It's just blah. Oh, interesting. You can reverse your controls and set up oscillations when burning. That's interesting, Soul Wager. Huh. We could always just turn them off, I guess, right? Interesting. Or we could move and then we could turn them off when we're burning and just use the engine gimbals or something like that. Alright, I am just a little bit perturbed. Look at this nonsense. I can't believe the freaking fillet. Alright, let's see what we can do here. Add a maneuver there. Periapses aren't the same, so this isn't going to work exactly. So let's move this around a little bit. You go a little bit further out, because we got to get there first, right? Set his target. We're going to bring in the big guns to get this thing to freaking arrow break, and hopefully I can get out there first. Probably not. Inclination's a little off, and I can't fix it from here. I can't fix it from there. That's annoying. Yep, that's not the right place to fix the inclination. That's okay. Take it easy, Wagglepuss. I'm perturbed because we had the asteroid set up for an arrow capture using like 9 meters per second of Delta V, and now that it's entered the sphere of influence, we didn't even warp through the sphere of influence. It says the periapsis is 2286. That gets on my nerves. Align dude, you could do that. Some people have done that. You could totally search for that. Whoa, here's Meister Carl. Hang on, let me look at these. Yeah, you could do that. You could totally Google that. There is a nice circular orbiter on the moon. I like it. Good job. That's wrong. It's gonna be there when we get there. That's annoying. Alex the Random, thanks for the follow. I appreciate you. There's not gonna be anything we can do to get there. Take it easy, TNT. Enjoy your green underglow. Gosh, no matter what, I'm just trying to go for small orbits. There we go, that's what we were looking for. All right. Okay, I would like that to happen right there. Because then I can just rendezvous on the way back. And if I could do this, maybe. There's so many. Gosh, it's so freaking messy. Get out of here. Get out of here. All these things can get out of here. I don't need that. I don't need that. I don't need that. Okay, now it's cleaned up. Right, y'all? Okay, so that's where our alignment is kicking in, right like that. And the rest of that is because of the plane change that would need to be done. Gonna have. Nice! Good luck on your interview! Good luck on your interview. That is awesome. Alright, how close is that? Not very, and that thing is moving with the quickness. So what is the close there? Separation 2-4 kilometers. That's actually not bad. Do you slingshot yourself from the moon or do a straight burn? Meister Carl, you do a straight burn. Don't slingshot yourself from the moon. There's no reason to do that. There's no need to do that. All right, let's get this trajectory mod out of here. And let's see here. If I did a plane change, could I meet it sooner, I wonder. I don't have ascending or descending nodes, apparently. Those are target positions. But I know about over here would be a good place to do a bit of a plane change. And then can we change the delta V that we use here? Okay, so that's gonna be way out there. I really just kind of want to meet it at the apoaps and start falling down with it. So how could I do that? It's actually gonna be pretty difficult to do. Because we've got to do the plane change out here at the side of the orbit, not up there. Dude, Steen Yar, thanks for the follow. And it's not giving. There's the ascending and descending nodes right there. That's interesting that it wasn't there before. 6.6 degrees. That was an ascending node, so we would need to go. Nope. That's weird. It does not know what's going on with the ascending and descending nodes. All right, that's actually closer. Look at that. That's probably the ascending or descending node based on some other orbit, which is not what I want. I wish you could turn the sun off. Oh, that's right, we were backwards. All right, come on. When it's there, it's still gonna be way out there. Soul Wager, it's Meister Carl's first mission. Just give them the easy way to do things. The easy way to do things. Alright, so we've got that at least. And now we just need to come up with some way to mate it out there. Less delta V is not the answer. More delta V is going to mean we have an insanely high velocity encounter. That's not what we want. This is pretty darn difficult to do with two maneuver nodes. That was close. Okay. That's closer. Ooh, that's pretty close. Look at that. Ooh, look at that. Ooh, that's actually really close. That's what I'm trying to do. Something along those lines. That's still not quite there, but that is what I'm trying to do right there. Hey, what's up, Alex the Random? How's it going? What's locked? What did I miss? Did I miss something? I haven't seen a lot of DOSes. Yeah, Angry Pink Tricycle. You saw it, Min. You saw it, Nubius. Angry Pink Tricycle was upside down because we were retrograde. I didn't even think about that. But that right there is what I'm trying to do. And I'm just trying to give myself so much time. But see, that's going to be too long. We can't meet it all the way out there. We have to meet it sooner than that. Or, I mean, later than that, really. So see, that right there is like where I'd like to meet it. I don't know why I'm spending so much time on this. There are easier ways to do this, but... that is kind of what I'm looking for. I don't really want to meet it at the Apple apps. I want myself to be falling down just a bit as well. So let's see here. See, that's too far. That's not it. What was that? Ooh, what was that? Moon encounter? Yep. Now I just need to wait a little longer, and I would like to meet it at that point in my orbit there. You see, I'm just... that's so close, though. Nope, that's not gonna do it. Dad, blame it. We only have 11 minutes to figure this note out. It's so freaking fine-tuned. And the tricky thing is, this is how we rendezvoused with the asteroid. And KSA, KSP just does not have the same computing power. Maybe burn his plan now and fix it apoapsis. I think it's too much of a separation to do that right now. I think that I should get a little bit closer before I do that. I think I had it before. I don't know what's going on with that stupidness, but it just thought that I dragged it for some reason. You have to be kidding me. No, 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 no. I don't know. I don't know what the deal with that is. It's been doing that today. How close can we get it? I think there's just such a fine... Ooh, look at that. What is that? In 10 days. That's in 1 hour. And then in 10 days, bam, 115 kilometers. That is definitely something we can do. Try to catch it on the rebound. I wanna arrow break it. So I wanna catch it before it makes its pass. We could catch it over there. That's actually not a bad idea. That one, yeah. What is this? This is in... One hour, and that one's in 10 days. When is that periaps? That's in 12 days. So that's awesome. That is awesome. That's going to be two burns to accomplish. We've got nuclear engines. That's 299. Engineer is going to tell us that that is going to be an 8-second burn, which is fine. That's not true at all. Huh. Interesting. It thinks that the burn time is going to be 4, 6 minutes. Now I bet you it's right. All right. So 50, 40, 30, 20, 10. All right, let's see here. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. That's annoying. We'll be fine. Alright, that was not the most accurate burn. Wow, that burn's gonna be $8.99. Seriously, come on. There it is. $187, $204, $92. I'll take it. Yeah, that's a really cool sheet, Lucifer. The cheat sheet is definitely cool. Alright. This pod is so annoying. I wish I didn't have it up there. Well, what can you do? Couldn't we balance it by thrust limiting these engines? No, we could balance it by thrust limiting these engines. Let's just put them at like 80 and see how it works. Because that should flip us around less. But this amount of thrust is going to be so much more than anything else. Whatever. Alright. It's going to be 11 second burn. Let's just get this. It's 27 minutes. So we're basically going to do an orbit. And come around again. SOI change. I don't care. Claw it! I'm definitely gonna claw it. I am definitely gonna claw it. Yeah, Lucifer, I totally appreciate you helping out all this stuff over there too. Cy Young Mi agrees, it looks like. Or I agree with Cy Young Mi, I mean. Look at these things going by. 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8. What's up, Niche? 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. It's going to be 11 second burn, so 22, 20, 12, 24 second burn. Roughly. Apparently, the game agrees. I'd rather listen to... Das, once a minute, my kids say goodnight. Meat Bates kids! Y'all get some sleep and behave. You have an awesome dad. Take it easy, and thanks for hanging out with us. We're gonna get this asteroid. We're going to get this freaking asteroid. I guarantee you. Positively, whatever, we are going to go get this asteroid. 17, 16, 15. Ninja lurking skills fail. Not in my channel, Niche. Look at that, we're balanced just by thrust limiting those engines a little bit. Ha! How are we doing on the pitch? Ooh, it's giving us quite a bit of pitch control there. I could actually thrust limit them a little bit more. That's 69. 69, how's our pitch? Yep, that's less pitch, so 58. 58. That's less pitch too, it looks like. Whoa, buddy. Alright, let's see how close that was. Interestingly, we have no encounter. We probably just didn't burn it very well. There's the moon again. There it was. It flashed for a second. There it is. That's what we're looking for. Where the heck did it go, though? There. It's flashing. There it is. Okay. Then we just use prograde retrograde to get it in. Oh my gosh. It's dragging the node. Are you freaking kidding me? There's the moon again. There was that. There is that. I think something is seriously wrong. It said it performed 3 landings? Really? I was wondering what the niche shoutout was about. I'm paying attention. I pay attention to things. I see what's going on. That is not good. Look, it's totally borked. It is totally borked. And it's dragging our node around. Every time we try to drag this, it actually moves the node. Ah, yes. For all your precise orbital planning needs. There was the moon again. We keep hitting the moon. There it was, right there. Okay, we got it back. I'm not trying to move that. Oh my gosh. Now it's... Every time we try to do that, it also moves the... probably because we're retrograde. Alright, that's us escaping. Then we go like this really slow. Okay, that's when it appears. No, I'm not trying to drag the node. I promise you. Okay. We had it. I did it like Adam. An hour or something? Did it add an orbit? There. See, it's there. It's just so freaking tweaky. Plus, that's right there at the apoapsis. That's not even what we really want. What is the deal with that? What is this node? Coming up in a different... at the wrong time or something? Oh, I'm getting a little bit annoyed with these nodes. Take it easy, Glass Eye Marmaduke. Take it easy. There's the moon again. Thirteen days? That's a problem. 13 days. Oh. We're already right there. It already flew past the node, it looks like. That's why it's all borked. Because it has already passed the node. And now we don't have the descending nodes all the way back behind us now. Well, what can you do? Not much. Not much. That's what happened. Right there. There it is. Okay. That's what we needed. We just passed the node, and so it added an entire orbit to it without us knowing. 142. All right. That's what we needed to do. 4 meters per second worth of correction. It should go bing. Yeah, the Hark, we know. The comet is coming in retrograde. The asteroid is coming in retrograde. Let me do this. Alarm clock. Add alarm. There we go. Yeah, the comet is coming in retrograde. We didn't have enough delta V to change it to a prograde orbit, so we actually launched this thing retrograde, and we're going to put it in a retrograde orbit, work on it. Or I think maybe if we catch it soon enough, we can switch its orbit without spending too much delta V. That's what we were trying to do. But it's a bit of a problem. It's just annoying. I had it in an aerobrake trajectory and the game lost it. Because it went through the SOI, and whenever it went through the SOI, it suddenly decided that it no longer had an aerobrake trajectory. And instead, it's at like 200,000 kilometers. Periaps. Which is okay. We'll figure it out. Another F5 for safety. Dude, good one, 1981. Good one. Hey, that's a good idea too. Only use the nukes for the precision burn. And we'll throttle these all the way up. The balance is a problem. The fact that that guy is up there is a bit of a problem. We should have balanced it better. Oh, we're supposed to be burning too. Well, we'll be fine. There we go. Now what do we have? 251. That's what we were trying to do. From that orbit, I don't think we're going to switch it to a prograde orbit. We may be able to aerobrake it. I was hoping to catch it up there, but we would have had to send the ship a lot sooner. And it's almost impossible to plan that. Let's see here. Love that RCS. For tweaking orbits. Wow, the RCS is even very finely controlled. So we're looking good there. So that looks good. Now, do we have a node coming up? No, the descending node is behind us. The ascending node would be the opposite end, so up here. Like that. So if we added a maneuver there, that's going to be descending, so this is going to be the ascending node, so we would burn Angry Pink Triangle to fix it. Let's go look at it. Oh yeah, the node is up behind me now. I can't actually look at it. There we go. 54. 61. 30. That looks good. I think 30 we can deal with. So now it's just a matter of timing. 0.7 meters per second. Was it possible the gravity of the moon threw off the original airbrake? We did not have a moon encounter whenever we came in. There was no moon coming in, so I don't know. I don't know why it lost it. It lost it twice in a row. We quicksaved two times and it kept losing it. But this will be good because little teeny tiny changes up at the top of this orbit. 0.7 meters per second, right? 0.7 meters per second of angry triangle at the top of this orbit. Well, it's not going to be that up there, but that should be good. This is in 6 days. We got to make sure that's right. That node is in 6 days. He is way out there. Alright, I think that'll be okay. Let's just go ahead and get up there. So many asteroids coming through this orbit, it's like a freaking shooting gallery. He's falling down towards Kerbin right now. Yep, there he goes, but he's picking up speed like crazy, and we don't have a lot of speed right now. We're gonna have to pick up speed. Ooh, 7 minutes. That's okay. That time warp. So let's just do RCS again. See how easy that is? Just tapping the RCS? That's the way to do it. Okay. Now, what can we do? We can just burn this live. So some prograde would probably work. Let's go see. That's retrograde. Intersect 1. In target position. Intersect 1. Target position. We need to burn prograde just a tad because it's going in ahead of us. So we just barely need to tweak our orbit. Prograde. So we have a little bit more speed. Because it's coming in at 281. We're only going 75 right now. We're closer, so the planet's going to be accelerating us faster, right? Yep, 25. Look at that. 20, 19, 18, 17, 16. 17 is about what we're going to get, so the rest of it's going to be an inclination change. And honestly, that right there is fine. That right there is fine. We can do the rest of it live. Ow, my eye is so annoying. Oh. Ah, that's okay. Alright, so we're fine now. Now we just need to wait till we get down here. If the game will allow me to put a node on the line with its errors. Come on, girly. Come on. No. Okay. That's just a timer. That's in 3 days. So we're going to be falling down for 3 days. Dude, Tarling did not know what he was signing up for whenever he went for this. Oh, and I don't need to point anywhere. I just need to go for 3 days. So we actually add an alarm. We're going to put it 5 minutes out this time, like that. Add alarm. Let's just go like this. And as soon as I grab this thing and freaking aerobrake it. Sweet. Come on. There we go. 2 days, 1 day, 0 days, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 hour, 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15. Alright, this should be 5 minutes out as well. So this should give us time to tweak this trajectory. We've got 153 meters per second. Where is the target? We've got to acquire the target. Or not. Let's just go do this. Alright, look at that. So now we can actually come in and fix this. Because we've got that, you can see how far we're off. That's where our difference is coming from. So I'm going to do the same thing I did last time. I'm just going to push that over. Let's zoom in now. And I'm just going to push that over. See, there's the KSA fillet and there's us. So I'm going to burn like this. Look at those weak, crazy rounding things there. That's what we want to do, though. It's doing the same thing, how it's hopping ahead like that. Alright, so that's down to 7.2 kilometers. And we are definitely getting there. Now we just need to burn like this and put that right over that. 4, 3, 2. What? Minimus encounter? What? How do we have a Minmus encounter? What is going on with this? RSM rules, 05, aerobrake. It's aerobrake, do they spell it? Yeah, aerobraking, it's using the air to slow down. It's totally using the air to slow down. So we're actually going to dive into the atmosphere of the planet and use the friction of the air to kill off some of our velocity. That is what we're going to try to do. Toggle the torque on that silly thing. Alright, acquiring the target, where is it? It's below or above us, I think. There it is, right back there. Okay. So now we have an encounter up there somewhere. Where we cross, that's where I'm going to need to claim. You see where those two lines cross? It's amazing that on this orbit I have a Minmus encounter. That makes no sense to me. Yeah, I did say, there you go. So to get Minmus, here's what you do. Congratulations. Welcome to Minmus. All you do is all this crazy stuff. Oh, brother. Yes, I'm trying to dip into... Yep, you got it. All right. Okay. Okie dokie. Let's burn a little bit more like that. We have to keep some of this velocity. So there's 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. What's my acceleration? 4 meters per second. That's not great, but that's only going to take us about 20 seconds to burn off 80 meters per second. So let's bend this some more and put it right down by 80. Eh, 70's fine. We should have an insane encounter now. With this distance, 0.1 kilometers. We have a rendezvous with the asteroid. Watch, the game's going to glitch and bug. Hey, F5 for safety. Lulz, man boy, what's going on? Align, dude, you have to increase the conic patches or something like that. And that will help you out with that stuff. Look how close we're going to get to the fillet. Look at the asteroid. You can see it right there. You can actually see it on the screen. That is the asteroid. So I'm going to start burning this off. 1.2 kilometers. That's 1,000 kilometers or 1,000 meters. 900 meters. 50 meters per second. Closing 40 meters per second. 30 meters per second. That's fine. Let's get it down to like 20-something. And again, I'm just chasing. There we go. 20. We would actually run into the asteroid right now. Alright. We could honestly just flip around right now. We could... Oh! Drink! 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 I swear it watches. It watches. Let's see how much RCS we've got. We have... Of course it'd be more efficient to use the nukes, but RCS, let's practice here. Ah, yes. We're gonna hit it. We gotta move. There we go. We don't want to hit it. The RCS was not going to be enough to slow us down, so let's grab it from the backside. Good times, good times. Think fast! We're going to hit it. Too good of a rendezvous. Oh, yes. Alright, boys, it was a blast, but a friend from high school that lives on the other side of the earth now just got on Steam. Nice. Dude, Meister Carl, take it off. Take it off. We designed it to grab the Class C, but we're also going to grab this one here. We designed it to grab everything, and I was sick of this one. Remember, originally we were going to aerobrake this one? And then we were going to, Alright. Nav hood engaged. There we go. Forward march. Alright. 3K says Volvo. I don't know what that means. MMR. I don't even know what any of that stuff means. You tried to orbit. All I did was crash. Dude, Lulz Manboy, if you come to a Kerbal Boot Camp, not this Saturday, but next Saturday, I will help you get into orbit. I will teach you everything you need to know to get into that orbit. That is what we do at Kerbal Boot Camp. Tarling. Can you get the asteroid, Tarling? Let's see here. Let's get the asteroid here. Oh, I love the hood, right? Alright, so that's good. And controlling from this pod, we can't actually... That's annoying. Alright, but that's good. We're good, we're good. So let's go ahead. We're going to go ahead and go for grapple here. We're going to try to grab this asteroid. So let's go ahead and activate our claw. Our freaking huge claw, remember? Yeah, I do have a Kerbal. He's in the pod right here, Mercenary, and he's going to grab this asteroid. Hopefully he's not going to crush the fillet. You can't. Volgar the Mighty, when you do an IVA view, you can no longer control from any other place. So IVA view automatically controls from the IVA view. And it's no bueno, mister. It's really, really, really annoying. I'm not, probably. I'm probably not going to name my craft after the ancient Egyptian temple. So, slow it on down. Alright. That looks cool. And I actually want to rotate. No. What is the right? There we go. I want to rotate like that and translate to the side. And I'm going to grab that big flat spot right there. We can actually turn off our spotlight now. That was interesting. Oh, we're clipped into it. The claw is huge. The claw is so huge. I thought we were still so far away from it. And we weren't. We were right against it. Look at it. I gave it a little bit of a spin. That's okay. We'll grab it while it's spinning. I had no depth perception whatsoever. Here, let's just go get it. I have no depth perception at all. And these controls are totally backwards. It looks like the tweak scale claw can't grab it, maybe? We've got the claw sunk into it. I gotta look at it from outside. I don't know what the deal is. It won't grab it. Huh. That's weird. What if the tweak scale claw is broken? I'm gonna be so angry if the tweak scale claw doesn't actually work. I got it, I think. I got it. I think I got it. I think I got it. You gotta slam into it. Yeah, it was almost impossible to see. That is a freaking grabber. I think we've got that thing. I think we've got that thing. I couldn't see the... Yeah. Plus, these RCS units are totally annoying. Should have thought of that. Don't need them. Now we've got it. Okay. I had no like frame of reference. It's like 2D. Oh, nice. Hug it. First, we gotta do target center of mass. And control from here. And free pivot. What is this? Did the asteroid not have a center of mass to target, or what? There it is. I can't, because the arm's on that side. We grabbed it too low. Shucks and darn and other things. Alright, well, we're going to have to fix that. I've got it! I'm not targeting the center of mass, but I've got it. Let's try to grab it in a more opportune area. No, remember, we've already answered that one a few times. We were going to go after the Class C asteroid, but then this one kept losing its arrow break, because I was going to arrow break this one into a capture on Kerbin, and so I said I was going to go after this one instead. Let's grab it in a more opportune location, like up here where it's flat. Because we're not able to quite rotate around enough here. Tarling's having a blast with this. Let's release that. Whoa! Let's go ahead and disarm, which fixes the claw. That puts some spin on it. That's a little annoying. Get it! Get it, Tarling! Get it! That spin, though, we'll grab it. We'll just crash into it. All right. Yeah, Vulgar, that's what I'm going to look for. I'm going to look for, like, this edge up here or something. Let's go for this big part that sticks out. Honestly, the pod just kind of blocks our vision. And this pod is not any good at grabbing. Control authority is all wrong in the pod. Let's just go get this thing. So this looks better. All of these are actually worthless. We didn't actually need those legs. Those were just Fashion Academy style. All right, here we go. Let's go ahead and grab this thing. Nope, didn't get it. Got it there. All right. Now we can target the center of mass. Now we can free the pivot. Now we can turn RCS off and actually go and target the middle of the center of gravity. Center of mass, sorry. Like that. This asteroid has a very weird mass. Then we can, when we're there, lock the pivot. Oop, nope. Free the pivot, lock the pivot. Target the center of mass. That's pretty close. Why does it keep losing the target? That's annoying. And look how, There we go. That asteroid is just weirdly shaped. But I don't think that we even need these. Yeah, that doesn't even do anything. That one just clips into it. That's okay, I guess. Now let's see if we can do that. Now let's see if we can do this. All right. If I burn radial in, is it too late to burn radial in? Well, it's apparently too freaking late to put a node on my orbit anywhere. We know how to fix that. We'll EVA Tarling and then put Tarling back in. And it still doesn't do it because the orbit is not closed. There you go. Sometimes if you can't put a node on there, you can actually find a place where you can put it and drag it to where you actually want it to be. But see how dumb the game is? It, like, thinks that I'm dragging it off. Oh, it lost it, didn't it? Gosh. I'm not dragging it off. Worst feature ever. Alright, let's see if we can't get into prograde orbit. What is that going to cost us? Not that much. 200, and you got to flip it. Come on. No. I need the other thing to be on the other side. There we go. So it's going to cost us like 200 to flip it and aero brake it. Nice. That is what we want. Okay. There we go. What's that parry apps? 60? 364. We've got that much. 46. 43. We can tweak the rest of it once we, And how much Delta V do we actually have? 1908. That's fine. Good thing we brought all this fuel and stuff, huh? Look at this. It's like we don't even have anything on us. It's just like, what? I'm going to turn. I don't care. Ah, yes. Still streaming, of course. I go to bed and DOS is streaming. I get up, he's streaming. I come home from work, DOS is still streaming. I haven't been streaming that long, though, have I? Maybe I have. We've been doing some seriously long missions. Alright. Can you explain why a counterclockwise approach is better? Because that way you get to add Kerbin's rotation speed. The speed that you have standing on the surface of Kerbin, that it rotates. You get to add that to your orbital velocity. So that's kind of a big deal, as it turns out. And it costs you like 400 or 500 meters per second. Burn! Okay. What is my thrust to weight just with the nuclear engines, I wonder? Acceleration, not much. Oh, wait, we still have the Philo. Wait, we have the Ophelia engines. That's what it looks like. You've got a big rock. Congratulations. You're like, shut up and burn. Control from there. There we go. Now we look good. Do I play Robocraft? No, I do not. Now we've got four engines. Acceleration is 3.11 meters per second. So it's going to be a 100 second burn to do it this way. Let's try it. What's our total ship mass? Mass. 77. Yeah, okay. There we go. Burning along. Look how hilarious it looks. It's like totally got a huge thing. There's a miniature claw and then there's this thing. Tug, 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 tug. It's got like a little probe on top of it that we're going to use. Tug, 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 tug. This is how we do a Philae mission. Ah, yes. Let's see here. That looks good, and we could actually turn on atmospheric trajectories. Yes. Burn. Burn. Towing service, wrong parking. Yeah, I did say that, and then we had the issues with the asteroids not aero-braking, which really got on my nerves. It's almost like a lot of times the annoyances with the game cause you to play for longer. Alright, now we're getting into a prograde orbit. If Kerbin can't come to the comet will come to Kerbin. We're gonna burn Philae off the front of this comet, by the way, this asteroid. We're just gonna aerobreak with Philae on the front side. What is my parry apps? 69. Alright, tell me what you're gonna do. There you go. Using that RCS. That right there is a two. This place is a mess! Look at all this junk flying around here. None of it's mine, even. Alright. So that looks pretty good. Convio, it is atmospheric trajectories, it's called. Atmospheric trajectories. Coded threat. The first time I played KSP, I was like 11 p.m. and suddenly it was 5 a.m. I was like, but I'm just getting the idea. I totally agree with you, man. Time warping or something? Das, do you think the RCS just should push on parts like engines do? Yeah, I think so. Sounds good to me. We're gonna turn this thing and see if we can't rip ourselves a little lander probe off of it. There we go. And that says we're totally going to crash into Kerbin. That's not good. Alright, and I've got big enough engines on here that we should be good. I thought you were targeting a 600 kilometer orbit. When we didn't have all this control authority, I was to give myself more time to react, right? Because we only had 90 meters per second of thrust on the little Philae probe. Now that we've got this huge thing there, it's not a big deal. It's a DOS extravaganza. I just looked at my Twitch following page. It's nothing but DOS. Live channels, DOS. Host, Shimmy the JJ, hosting DOS. Earthworm Slim, hosting DOS. KSP TV, hosting DOS. Mater, hosting DOS. Ah, yes. We're gonna do something with it. We built ourselves a huge freaking probe, and we are about to scrape Philae off the front of it. Alright, anyways, F5 for safety, right here. And let's go for the, oh, brother. Claw bug. Okay. I can't time warp with the claw. Maybe if I'm not looking at it, it won't break. That's totally how it works, isn't it? Is that the Dr. Pepetta? Yes, it is. Okay. Maybe if I'm not looking at it, it won't break. It is gonna... Watch how fast it starts to accelerate. It's gonna accelerate so ridiculously fast all of a sudden. As you do. Morning, Cube Jam. What's going on? Alright, let's go look at it. There's Kerbin. We are bringing you a present, Kerbin. A space rock. Look at that. Isn't that pretty, though? That sunrise on Kerbin, though. Look at that. This crap looks ridiculous, by the way. Could you slingshot it to the moon? You probably could, but what I'm going to do is put it in orbit around Kerbin and do some stuff with it. And then, quick install deadly reentry. It breaks everything, yeah. Alright, we're definitely not going to do this in real time, but look at this pretty screenshot. Look at that, it like completely goes wacky. We're already going 3 kilometers a second. 3.1, alright, here we come into, oh yes, thank you. Hide behind the asteroid! Everybody except for Philae. Take it easy, T-Game. We're about to aerobrake this asteroid. Honestly, looks ridiculous. Ridiculously awesome. Magnipedes, thanks for the follow. I appreciate it. Did I miss anybody? Franklin Renzonda. Look at it! I'm coming for you, KSC. That would actually make a great desktop background right there. What's up, Caretaker 83? 38, actually. It is time for us to start the arrow breaking. Scroll on down, Afram. Afraram. I've got a list of the must-have mods that I think you should have. That are very interesting and informative mods. You should totally have a look at them. Uh-oh. No. One of our RCS ports is getting a little bit of heating. We are actually hiding behind the asteroid almost completely. Look. Philae's got some trouble up there. But we are almost completely behind the asteroid. Yo, dog, I heard you needed a heat shield. Poor Philae. But we're cool. Literally. Didn't. There, look, I've got my entire craft behind the asteroid. Except for that one landing leg. That is amazing, honestly. Who would have thought that that would have worked? It's a huge heat shield. Every now and then that leg gets a little bit. One order of filet, well done. That's hilarious. Turn your head to the Kerbal and say something inspirational. Wait, how would I do that? Oh, he's not even in this. Which way is he? Regolith, thanks for the follow. I don't think you went deep enough. Oh, we're still arrow breaking. Look at that. Stone-baked filet. Filet will protect the asteroid. I just wanted an asteroid, so I went and got one. That's all. This is all I can think of when I see this craft. What is this? The gravity gun. The gravity gun. That's awesome. What is this? Das, if there were any undiscovered naturally occurring heavy metals, and place to find them would be Mercury or Venus. Mercury and Venus, logically speaking, the heaviest elements. So Mercury and Venus with the highest concentration of heaviest. Are we gonna go there and like get some of them? That sounds good to me. I would be all about that. Look at that arrow break, though. Philae's fine. The asteroid tug is fine. That was the portal gun. Oh, that was the portal gun. Wait, I didn't even. Hang on a second. It is the portal gun. Dang it. What is that potato looking thing? Is that Portal 2? I did not play Portal 2 yet. I was thinking of the gravity gun. I was thinking of the gravity gun. The potato is the asteroid. My bad. I think this is more like the gravity gun than the potato gun, the portal gun. My bad. My bad. Portal 2 spoilers! Yeah, I haven't seen Portal 2. We should put a little pod on the front with a claw that he can, like a cupola on the front. It's a potato. Alright, we're fine. Now we have an asteroid. I don't have any more snacks. That gets on my nerves. What's up, Crispy? How's it going? No, I'm going to play it at some point. I have it, I just haven't played it. A plate on the front in a seat and a Kerbal riding the asteroid down. Of course I should. You would think that I should do that, wouldn't you? Let's get that out of there. We still have 1714. Giddy up, Philae! Yeehaw! Why is the Dr. Pepetta actually crashing into Kerbin? Whatever, man. Can I record my gameplay? Do you want me to stream Portal 2? I've never played Portal 2. Do you want me to just play Portal 2 on the stream? People probably be like, dude, this dude's behind the times. I should totally stream Portal 2? Really? Maybe I will. Yes, I should stream Portal 2. I know lots of Portal 2 quotes. Maybe in my copious free time. What is this, Apo? 500? Let's raise it up to like 250. We'll do work on it at 250. I love this tug carrying this asteroid around. It's really making me happy. Kipcast! Yeah, scroll on down. I've got all the mods listed right down there at the bottom of the channel. I'm gonna send this up to 250. 250. Drink! Drink! That is by far the best mod ever. I should stream Portal 2. Continues to catch asteroids for 19 hours. Alright. We're good. We've got a periaps of that. Add maneuver. Bring it on down now, boss. Wait for the flip. And stop! 253 by 251, a little bit more. 251 by 252, a little bit more. 251 by 251, I'll take it. It's a wiener winner! Das, when do you usually burn when you want to create a perfectly circular orbit? Michaelinus, it depends on how much you need to do. It depends on how much delta V you need to do. You need to burn as close to the periaps or apoaps as you can. So if you, it may take you a couple burns if you've got too much burn to circularize. If you have to spend too much delta V to do it, you may need to do that, like, over time. Let's go ahead and break. Look how it breaks. Why does it break like that? Philae is doing a sweet ollie off the asteroid, apparently. It's just like, what's up? I'm Philae. Les Claypool, that is probably a recipe for disaster, but that is one of the most awesome ideas I've ever heard. Have a circular space station that orbits retrograde and an asteroid that comes flying through it every now and then. That would be hilarious. That would be absolutely hilarious. Maybe we can get it to go through it once. Das, woo! Das stream from a new laptop. Congratulations on your new laptop. Blipman. How long have I spent? I should just stick to the non-complicated. How are my nuclear engines overheating? Seriously? Philae is doing fine. Hal Soy, it's right there. It's attached to the asteroid that we're bringing home. Apparently, Philae liked the asteroid so much it brought its big brother, Feeler, or something. 5-4 by 258. Yeah, that wasn't a circular burn, but that's fine. Kid Shank, we're taking it right freaking here. I'm going to stretch for a second. We are taking it right here to a mostly circular orbit around Kerbin. The only other thing that we could do is maybe set the moon as the target. And we are prograde, right? Yep, we're going left or right. 2.6 degrees, so we could totally come over here, and at the ascending node, we could add a maneuver to normalize like this. Oh, that's the ascending node. There we go, 0.1. All right. Ah, I'm gonna sync out my stream for a second. Can you make an asteroid necklace with double-sided claws? I should stick to easy missions. Spends the next 2 weeks trying to land on Jewel. You're probably right. This rock weighs nothing. It's so tiny. Tweak scale makes it easy to move asteroids around. If this was a normal little claw, we would have nothing but trouble. I really don't understand how they didn't put multiple claws in here. Alright. So 15 minutes, we got a 26 second burn. Let's just get to it fast. Philae's doing its sweet aerial maneuver again. Boing, and then it undoes it. It's amazing that it's not completely crashing the game when we do that. But whatever. It's in space. It weighs nothing. Not true, because there is local gravity here. So it does have some sort of weight. It definitely has the same amount of mass and inertia, I'll have you know. Hey, that's actually something for Cybertech. Look at that. It's calculating the node burn time incorrectly. Turbo power! Did y'all see that? Oh, the sound. It sounds like the Predator. You're right. It does kind of sound like the Predator. That right there, what is that, 256 by 248? Folks, that is a nice circular orbit with an asteroid around Kerbin. We should totally go tackle a Class E with that thing. Let's go to the Dr. Pepetto right quick and finish it up. Where is Kerbin? I need to get eyes on Kerbin. There it is. We're falling sideways towards it. Okay. Success! Yeah, we got it. Yeah, I don't know. Either way, I bet you Cybertech could fix it. Time for it. Welcome to the channel, by the way. I bet you Cybertech could fix it, whatever it is. We are totally going to crash. We are totally going to crash. That's not a good thing, usually. We try not to do that on occasion, and that is us actually hitting the planet. So to fix that, we need a little bit of radial out. That is radial in. Let's flip around and go radial out. Let our main engines just a little bit. That is going to tweak our orbit just up a little bit like this. There we go. Then we're going to miss the planet. Then we've got an aero brake maneuver, right, like that. Same deal, different day. Let's see how accurate of an aero brake maneuver we can get. Given the types and tones of the 650, I would assume it has a nickel iron core. If the sound comes with a magnetic field, interesting. Can we farm it? I would love to farm it. That would be awesome if we could farm asteroids. It's like, oh, need more silicone for solar panels here. How about we fix that for you? Let me get you some more silicone for solar panels. That is pretty darn close right there. That guy's in, what, 100 orbit? That is going to be a really close aero break. The Dr. Pepetta may not make it. May not survive. Let's go ahead and retract the panels. Times two. RCS off. Where's the planet? Let's point prograde. This is the most ridiculous looking ship that I have made, and I love it like it is each of my children's. Oh, seriously? Alright. Nice. Okay. To Kerbin. We are falling towards Kerbin. We are going to do an aero break in the delicious Dr. Pepper probe here. It looks like we're going to miss Kerbin. But gravity doesn't work that way. Gravity doesn't work that way. We are not gonna miss Kerbin. I don't disagree. And having a station on the moon would mean that we would already be harvesting asteroids. But no! We decided that we didn't need to go to the moon or Mars or anything like that. Do I have a YouTube car? How do you call your new pet asteroid? I call it... Asteroid 80211B is what I had it named. Now that we have it there, maybe we could do something different. I don't know. Let's see how this arrow breaking works. Meteor cut in half. Wait, let me look at this. Looks like something we built. That says naturally how it forms, Andrea? A total of 16 people are hosting us. What? Oh, brother. And we are just killing orbital velocity. We've already arrow captured, and we are killing that orbital velocity by going through the atmosphere. I don't even have my engines on or anything. Dark Omen, get some sleep. Get your buns to sleep. That's just fine. I'm getting pretty tired too. This is... spent a lot more time on this than we thought. Volgar, what's the problem with that, sending it back up into space? It sounds like then we would have to develop new and better technologies for sending things into space, and that doesn't sound like a bad idea, does it? Does it? I'm not complaining, Blipman. I'm totally not complaining. I'm just, like, sitting here through this arrow break. Let's just time warp through the arrow break. We bled off almost a kilometer per second of velocity by going through the atmosphere, which is cool. That is what we wanted to do. They form more like crystals than metal deposits. That's awesome. I did not know that. You blame me and squad for your lack of sleep. You have no one to blame but blame itself. And we're out of the atmosphere. Enough. We're out enough of the atmosphere. Oh, come on. If it would be easier. Well, why would we have to ship it back here? Why couldn't we build things on Mars? In fact, I would rather mine the materials on Mars and build cities on Mars than ship them back into space. In fact, I would rather get to Mars and mine Mars instead of having an asteroid and having to figure out how to ship the materials down to the base of Mars so we could live there. And that's my two cents. Honestly, we should have been on the moon 30 years ago. We should already have a permanent base there. And we don't. Because we're lame. This collision course happening here. Hang on a second. Something is going to pass us at a high rate of speed. Mine all the Mars! There it went. What was it? Something was 30 kilometers away. The delicious delivery again. Until Cold War 2 is official. Only a matter of time, I know. I know. Why are we in a retrograde orbit? Well, what could you do? Fake asteroid? What does a fake asteroid mean? Space elevator for Mars. Nice! I approve. Honestly, we just need to get off our bums and do some stuff. Yeah, it'll be a thing. It'll be a thing. It will be a thing. I don't disagree that it'll be a thing. I'll be okay with it, honestly. What did I miss? Did I miss something? Okay, the Dr. Pepetta probe is also successfully rescued. Another successful procedure. So I've played some TF2. Das, what is the mod with the black bar in the top left of the screen? I believe someone answered and said that it is Blizzy's toolbar. Steel Mage told you it's Blizzy's toolbar right there. Blizzy's toolbar. Blizzy's toolbar. Okay. We've basically cleaned everything up. Did this one get captured? No, it's escaping Kerbin in a day. That's not it. What about this one? There's a Class C that's escaping Kerbin soon in a very wacky orbit. We could totally go that one to get a Minmus or something. Not right now. What do you have to do in this game? Victa! You do whatever you want. You do whatever you want. You can build space stations. You can build rovers. You can build bases on the ground. You can build spaceships, you can build huge rockets, you can crash huge rockets. You can capture asteroids. We actually just captured an asteroid. You can drink delicious Dr. Pepper. There's tons of things you can do. I can't believe that got captured. Is it? That is increasing, so it's escaping right now. Alright, that's fine. Do what you want, but don't do it around me. What does that mean? I'm reading some chat here. Hey. I like explosions. Okay. Alright. We have spent a lot more time on Long Dark. We've spent a lot more time on this game than we expected to spend on this game. For sure, for sure. Because we were supposed to play some Long Dark. Who's awake right now? Because there's no one streaming Kerbal Space Program. What's going on? There's nobody streaming Kerbal Space Program. Who's awake right now? Who is awake? Who are these people? We could play lawn darts instead. Washproof. I'm honestly okay with that. I am honestly okay with somebody putting up an orbital hotel because we'll gain a lot from it. Even if it's a commercial thing, we will learn a lot. Host myself. You want me to host myself? I totally need another drink or some tea. Dude, Fezzy, what's going on? Slayer McGee's here. Soul Wager's here. Danish27's here. Meatbait's here. Align Dude. Oh, talking about... Nice. Cy Young Mi's away. Cy Young Mi, thank you again for the donation earlier. That was awesome of you. I think you would have fun playing Dota 2. Nope. Not me. That's really not my type of game. I have streamed KSP a few times, but no much better than streaming with you, Dudas. Everyone is hosting you and went to bed. Oh my gosh. Earthworm Slim's asleep. Earthworm Slim, man, I've had some freaking marathon streams the last 2 nights. Yeah, no, check it out. I totally got the boulder. I'll show you. Look. The KSA hugs. The KSA hugs is totally toting a boulder right now in a nice prograde circular orbit, and we're going to do something with it. Check it out. The KSA hugs is totally here. Holding a huge asteroid. It can totally chill out with it. Yeah, Slim, I'm honestly not going to be able to stream all weekend, so I'm kind of like burning the candle at both ends right now, because I'm not going to stream for like the next 4 days. I'm going to stream tomorrow, and then I'm not going to stream Friday, Saturday, Sunday, 3 days at least. So, the KSA hugs. We are not on the center of mass anymore, interestingly. It doesn't look like we're on the center of mass, honestly. Let's go ahead and rotate so that we're on the center of mass. Oh, I didn't know you could do that. No, you can't do that. Okay. So we actually... Thank you. There's the keys, yeah. So we totally caught ourselves an asteroid, Slim. Check it out. We put Philae on the asteroid, and then we built Philae's big brother with the huge friggin' claw, and we grabbed the entire asteroid and brought Philae and the asteroid back home to Kerbin. So that was good times. That was totally good times. Oh, brother. You've been watching. Oh, man. We've just been kind of hanging out, and I've like half playing and half not playing and, you know, just kind of chilling out. I could play Long Dark for an hour or something like that. Blah. I should probably just go to sleep. I should probably really just go to sleep. I should do Long Dark. Yeah, we grabbed a B-class. We were testing out this thing, and we found some bugs with it. So we totally need to fix... No, Cube Jam, there's one that's a lot bigger than this. A lot bigger than this. Yes. I think that we need to go to sleep. It's probably time for me to go to sleep, honestly. I did stay up late yesterday. I did. I stayed up way late doing an epic mission. And we've accomplished all these here. I'll play some Long Dark tomorrow. I'll do my KSP thing at 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. I may stream before that. I don't know. DK's not going to be able to stream tomorrow from what I hear. So I may stream in DK's place. But I do need to get caught up on my sleep, and I do have a class today. I have a class that I have to go to at 4, so I should probably go to sleep. Slim, is there anybody we should raid? I see Saiyan. I was going to raid Saiyan, maybe, because I don't see anybody else. I don't see anybody else. What should we do? We got to raid somebody. Yeah, I know. He tweeted about it, actually. I saw his tweet. I was actually streaming, and I saw his tweet about that. That's awesome that he came over to look at RoboCraft. Good deal. Yeah, this is a Class B. We were going to get a Class C. He's the only quality streamer I have logged on. Playing Dark Souls, though, that's a different... that is a totally different audience, for sure. Y'all want to do 2 raids? Can we do 2 raids? Let me see if either of these guys have a mic. 0 viewers on this guy and 0 viewers on this guy. Let me see if they have mics. Survey says he's got a viewer now. He's got a camera playing his kittens, I guess. Is this thing just spinning randomly? Is he even controlling it? Huh. I don't think this guy's playing right now. He's just got a probe randomly spinning around, which is interesting. He's got a Kerbal on a command chair with a single tank of LFO that is in orbit for some reason. But I don't think this guy's playing. He's got the kitten cam up and his Kerbal's just spinning around. Alright, I don't think that guy's playing. Let me try this one. Take it easy, Soul Wager. We'll catch you tomorrow. This guy's just streaming his Steam desktop. It's like he fell asleep streaming his Steam desktop. What the heck? Wednesdays are usually dead for streamer. I wonder why. Lots of people take the day off. Interesting. Huh. You know something is complex if you come across too many bugs. Yeah, that guy's streaming his desktop. That's not gonna work. Anybody? Yeah, it looks like it, Crispy. See what Satan's doing. It's 8 in the morning. That's not very funny, USM. I mean, I appreciate you hanging out. I get the joke, but...
Yo, what's up, Mosk? Dude, Mosk, man. What's up, dude?
Satan doesn't have his camera on. That's
interesting. I haven't actually had, like, the opportunity to talk with you, like, in a while outside of Z's, so how are you doing, too?
We should totally... I guess we should raid Satan. Like, I think we should raid Satan. Because we're Nunzo.
Oh, Moscow guys, by the way, he's
late for the flight. Take it easy, Luis.
Streaming here on Twitch.
Yeah, that's Saiyan. Alright, if y'all want to raid somebody, I've never raided Saiyan before. I don't even think he knows who I am, but Slim. Oh, he only turned it on for 9k follows. I gotcha. Gotcha. Well, let's go raid Saiyan. Let's go raid Saiyan. Because I've never raided Saiyan before, and we'll go say hi to him. And see how that goes. Where are the chiptunes so that I can turn them off? There we go. So we're basically shutting it down here, but we're going to go on a raid if y'all want to go. Saiyan is playing Dark Souls, apparently, so it's a totally different type of game. It's a totally different type of game. So let's see how many people. I'll read out all the things. I will read out all the people. There's Earthworm Slim with a Saiyan love. Nice, nice. He's on Twitch. He's playing Black Ops 2 Origins. There we go. We've got all that stuff. Let me unmute Saiyan.
Yeah, I'm actually doing pretty well. I'm doing pretty well. Today's been a really, like, draining day for
And
me,
let's go over and raid Saiyan.
It's kind of
draining. Here's a link. Playing Dark Souls. So a totally different game. I've never raided a Dark Souls stream before. Go over there. Raid Saiyan and say a... Das... What should we say? File love? Das file love? Like that? That may be good. Let's see how many people go over there and just say hi to Saiyan. He's awesome. Slim vouches for him, right? Slim, you vouch for him. So go over there and give it a nice Das File Love. Blip, man, you're too early. It's Das File Love.
Thank you guys for the followers.
There you go. Das File Love.
Thank you. This is what I get. This is the struggle. I love saying thank you to you guys. I really do. But sometimes I end up dying horribly.
Nice. I've never... I think it's just the games he plays. I think it's just the games he plays. I've never heard him, like, cursing... off or anything.
Oh, snap.
What's a DOS raid?
Love all around, ladies and gentlemen. Love all around. Let's go ahead and welcome everybody. Welcome, everybody. Welcome. How are you guys doing? Welcome.
Nice. What's up, Artivine?
I'm... Can't say. I'm not sure who exactly is it that I am,
thank he doesn't
you for
know.
Thank you very much.
Nobody!
I really appreciate you guys coming on out.
Wow, that's a lot of people. I'm actually reading all the names.
Throw me like a name. Who's Blitman. I'm curious.
Meatbait. Sayumi. Fezzy. Align Dude. Saiyakon. Earthworm.
But, yeah.
Thylo. Puppetman Bear. Cube Jam. Robata made it.
TNT Zezman. Me. But in the meantime, thank you all for coming on out on the raid. Thank you very much for the support.
Who else?
So it's Dos Valdez. All right, thank you guys. Thank you guys.
Slayer.
So let me get him linked up.
Lord Tetchy. Nubius made it. Akito Senshi.
Thank you so much. I can't Jer say Kittose, I have the pleasure
Lord Tetchy, Robata,
I misspelled
that. Meat Bait. That was twice. Oh, you said you were answering him.
I might have misspelled that.
I might have misspelled it.
I think that's it. Let me try again. Let me try again.
How do you print it?
There we go. I think that's it. Did I fix it now? I did it. Cool. So it looks like we're doing some Kerbal Space Program. That's actually a really, really fun game. Learn a lot about space, dude. Learn a lot about space. I guess that's because of the new comet landing. The new comet landing hype. So yeah. Welcome, everybody, and don't spoil this. Like, how are you doing, man? What's going on? Again, I can't say I've had the pleasure, so...
There we go.
Would you mind telling us a little bit about yourself? And for anybody who might not know you...
There was somebody behind you.
So, like, what kind of stuff nice. Do you do? And
he greeted us, and the boss killed him immediately.
I appreciate that. For anybody you're here who does not know him or...
Sparks McCool, thanks.
He raided us. That's awesome.
Who knows where you are?
He really, really is. So throw that dude a follow. Throw him some love. Show him some
respect. He doesn't know who I am. That's all good.
The only way to treat a raid is with love. It really, really is.
Ah, yes.
He's got something right. Go, oh, snap, how did I just live?
What we do in KSP, we explode just like in Dark Souls.
Fine, I'm fine with that. I'm confused more than anything right now.
Ah, yes.
Asteroids and honor affiliates. Nice. Very, very
good. Oh, nice. We got him over 300. Excellent. Good deal.
So real quick, folks, too, let me just go ahead and make sure I click that name. Let me go ahead and follow you up, too. I just want to make sure I got you followed as well.
Oh, surprise. Yeah. I'm totally following you. Wait.
Hey, everybody.
Saiyan is following the channel.
Not already.
Thanks for the follow, Saiyan.
Right now, I want to see some love for Das Valdez. I want to see, guys, if you have followed him, say I followed Das Valdez. If you already
nice.
Do follow me, come along.
Dude.
Feel free to say I already do. And feel free to. I want to see some love for that. I want to see.
I am going to crash out.
Guys. A proper reception.
I am going to stream tomorrow because I've got my KSA. I'll be doing some remote tech, which I don't know. Remote tech and antenna range. I'm going to look at both of them, I think.
I want to see the love in the chat.
But I am going to crash out for now. Let me mute him for just a second. There we go. I am going to go ahead and close down the stream right now. I'm done. I am done. If you want, follow Saiyan. He's just an awesome guy. He, like, seems really nice, and he, like, greets everybody and says cool things, and he's got a cool voice. So you should probably give him a follow just for random stuff. You know? But I am going to go ahead and close down my stream right now. I'm donezo. We captured some asteroids. Philae hype. We totally did an entire Philae mission, which was cool. Which was cool. But for now, I am done. I'll be back tomorrow. I will probably stream a little bit earlier, and I will be going to sleep a lot sooner than this. A lot sooner than this, for sure. So, I am going to close it down for now. Look at all those follows coming in. That's cool. Mr. Zadix, Adake9, Stance225, who else? Quite a few follows, although they may not even be on my channel. If you are, that's all good. I appreciate the follows if you can hear me. And if not, that's also good as well. Stance, Beatalize, Mr. Zevex, Adake9, Saiyan. That's awesome. But for now, I am done. I'll shut it down. I'll see y'all tomorrow. We'll be doing some remote tech, some antenna range, seeing how that connects things. We're going to geosynchronous orbit. We're going to have to do that. And I'm going to try to do a lighter stream tomorrow because I've taken the weekend off. So I'm not streaming all weekend for the next 3-4 days after tomorrow. So I am done for now. As always, I appreciate all the donations. I appreciate all the people hanging out. I appreciate the cool information we were sharing in the chat. I appreciate everybody. Dude, especially Lucifer. Shout out to Lucifer, who was giving out some really good help this evening in the channel. I really appreciate you, Lucifer, and I noticed stuff like that for sure. So thank you so much. I'm shutting it down. I'll go hang out with Saiyan and watch him fight this, whatever this thing he's fighting for a while. We'll see how it goes. But for now, I am done. I don't even know where to turn this thing off at. There we go. And I will catch y'all next time. Good games.